Guys, I have some big news. Nala and I are famous now. So I think when we go to the dog park, we're probably gonna have to wear some sunglasses. Good thing for the masks because it's crazy out here. And welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I am going to share my best tips and tricks for how to go viral on TikTok after I just went viral. Woohoo! That was the coolest experience of my life. I'm gonna give a quick little story time of how it happened. But if you are new here, welcome. I'm so happy that you decided to join me. Please hit the subscribe button before you leave. And please give this video a big thumbs up at the end if you enjoyed it. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for coming to check out my channel. And if you're back, welcome back. I'm so happy to have you here. But I have recently gotten a TikTok. I haven't really like talked about it vocally in my YouTube videos. I just kind of put it in my description box if anybody wanted to check it out. But I do have a TikTok now. I got into it. I'm gonna tell you why in a second. And I had a video that went viral just recently. And so I thought that this video would be really fun to film so I can give you all my tips and tricks, because I know that a lot of people are curious as to how you can get your video to explode on TikTok. And so I'm gonna share my best advice with you, and hopefully TikTok does not get banned. Like, they're saying that it's gonna get banned, and if it does, well, we'll enjoy it while it lasts. Really quickly, I'm gonna tell you how my video went viral, and then I'm gonna go ahead and give you my tips and tricks. A couple of months ago, I'm gonna like speed this through really, really quick. A couple months ago, I was telling my sister-in-law, who works for a very famous YouTuber, that my YouTube channel was really struggling to grow and I didn't know what I was doing wrong, and I was asking her if she had any advice. She told me I should get a TikTok because the TikTok algorithm is absolutely insane. It's what pushes your videos to the top, whereas YouTube pushes more famous people and people who get more views and people who have higher watch time, it pushes them towards the top. And so it's a little bit harder to grow on YouTube. But her friend, who was a Twitch streamer, had gotten a TikTok and her videos were going like blowing up like crazy, and because of that, a lot of people were clicking on her profile, going to her Twitch stream, going to her YouTube channel, going to her Instagram, and so it was creating a domino effect that was helping her grow on other platforms. So I thought, okay, that's a really good idea. I'll start a TikTok, and then hopefully it will pour over into my YouTube channel, maybe my Instagram, maybe my podcast, and maybe it will help me out a little bit to help me grow. So I created a TikTok. I just really was doing fun videos. I did some Animal Crossing videos. I was doing mostly videos with Nala. That's pretty much all I did, was Animal Crossing and videos with Nala. But I want to do some more Disney videos. And I posted this video, which I'm gonna insert right now.
Oh, you're such a good boy. Oh, you're such a good boy. Who's a good dog? Who's a good dog? Who's a good dog? Oh, you're a good dog. You're a good dog. Who's a good dog? Are you a good dog? Who's a good dog? Are you a good dog? Are you a good dog? Who's a good dog? Who's a good dog?
And the video went very slow. Nothing happened. I was just like, oh, okay, it's just another TikTok video. And then almost two weeks later, I was going to bed one night and I just happened to like go on my TikTok, because I was just like scrolling before bed, and I saw that I had like so many comments, so many new followers, so many likes. I was like, what is happening? I noticed that they were all for the same video, so I was really confused. So I went to my page and I looked at the video and it had 18,500 views, and I was like, what the heck, is my video like blowing up right now? And I was getting really excited because every time I hit refresh, it had like another 500 views. It just kept blowing up like crazy, and I had never experienced this before. I mean, that night I went to bed with over 100,000 views. My YouTube channel, which I've been working on for 3 years, has 74,000 views in total now. So I was not used to this kind of explosion. I was not used to this many people having seen my content. So I could not sleep because I was so excited. I was watching the numbers go up and up and up. I was up for a couple hours just watching the numbers because I was like, this is insane. And I knew I had to get up early for work the next day, so I finally went to bed, and when I woke up, the video was at 450,000 views. And throughout the day I was checking it, I was so excited, and at night it had hit 950,000, I believe, and then the following day it hit 1 million. And currently, which is the day after, so it's been like 3 days now, I think, It is currently sitting at about 1.2 million. So that is really cool, and I feel really cool that that happened to me because I was not expecting it at all. So anyway, guys, if you would like to stab them with your TikTok videos, I'm gonna share with you my best tips and tricks. Of course, this is based off of my one video that has gone viral, but I'm hoping that these tips and tricks will help me for the future and will help my channel grow as well. So, ta-da! My first tip for you all to go viral on TikTok is to post something because you love it, not because it is trending. This is a big one to me, guys. If for some reason you see something that's trending and you really love it and you think you could do a great job with it, that's awesome, that's really good. Or if you see something that's trending and you think you could put your own original spin on it, that's even better, that's super cool. But if you just see something that's trending and you don't really love it and you're just doing it just to get the views, your viewers are gonna see that and they are just going to absolutely not care at all. Like, for example, I see so many people repeating videos that I have seen before, and I'm like, guys, this is like basically like saying the same tips and tricks, or basically saying like the same joke. I'm like, guys, this is not funny anymore because we already saw it from this person who blew it up originally. Or if it's like a dance TikTok and you can't dance, I mean, I'm sorry, but I cannot dance, so I understand the pain. But when I see those videos, I'm just like, no. Just do something because you love it, not because of the fact that it's trending. And I'm gonna go more into detail with that with other tips and tricks. The next tip I have is use your hashtags. Use as many characters as you can, and definitely use the hashtags FYP, For Your Page, For You Page. Those are all really good hashtags. I put them on every one of my TikToks that has room for it. Sometimes my caption is a little bit too long. So definitely use your hashtags. It's gonna help promote things, and people can also look up specific hashtags. So for example, Animal Crossing. I've been getting a lot of Animal Crossing people because I've been hashtagging Animal Crossing or Animal Crossing Switch or other hashtags of that nature. This is also a really good tip for YouTube channels because your keywords are huge in helping people find your videos. That's the reason that my Marvelous Miss Maisel video just got almost 6,000 views because of my keywords, because Google was pushing that video because it was getting searched for some of the keywords that I had put into that video. So your hashtags and your keywords are so important. The next one that I have is do not take the video down if it isn't doing well. Like I said, that video had been up for almost 2 weeks before anything even remotely huge had happened to it. I think it had like maybe 1,000 views before it took off that day. And if I had taken it down because I was like, oh, it's not really doing well, that never would have happened where it would have blown up like crazy like that. And so that is my best advice to you, is to leave your videos up if you think that they're good quality, if you think that they are good videos, leave them up. Of course, if they're bad videos, they're bad quality, then for sure, if you want to take them down, if you think that's the right decision. But don't take it down simply because of the fact that it is not growing, because you have no idea what could happen. This is also true of my YouTube videos. I try to do things that I love, even if they're not trending right now, and I leave them up because you never know if those things are gonna be trending in the future. And this is a huge, huge thing with my channel, because like I did a video, sorry for all the likes, that's one of my worst habits. I did a video a couple of years ago called Barbie Dreamhouse Adventures Hairstyles or something like that. And that video got pretty much no views. Today it has over 2,000 views, and every time I go to my analytics, it is still blowing up. Like, it's in my top 10 videos for the 28-day period. And this happens with a lot of videos of mine, actually, where they'll just randomly start getting popular again. Like my movie collection video, which I thought nobody was gonna watch, has I think 3,000 to 4,000 views right now. And I know those aren't huge in the scheme of things, because some YouTubers get millions of views or hundreds of thousands of views. But as a small YouTuber, those are really big things for me, because on average, my videos average like 175 to 100 views. So if I get anything more than that, that is huge for my channel. Definitely leave your videos up, because you never know when they're gonna go crazy. My next tip is to respond to and like every comment. I'm gonna talk about this in a second, but I got a lot of hate comments on this video. I'll talk about that in the future, but respond to as many as you possibly can. Respond to the nice ones, respond to the mean ones. You can be funny. That's what I usually do with hate comments, is I try to just play a joke with the hate comments, because I know that they're not real hate comments. I know that people are just sad right now because coronavirus is happening. I know people are just mean. So I just try to joke it off and play around with the comments, or I leave something nice for them that they can read instead. So respond to as many comments as you possibly can. When I did this, so like I said, when I went to bed, it was at like 100,000. The next day I went to like 450. It was starting to slow down a little bit, but that morning I responded to like, I don't know, like maybe 50 comments, and it started gaining more traction again because I think that the engagement was pushing it up in the algorithm again for TikTok. And this is especially important if you get a verified TikToker on your video. To respond to that comment, because that is going to bring more traffic from your channel from those pages, or to your TikTok pages, that I meant to say, from those pages, and that is going to be huge to keep your video going viral. So definitely respond to every comment, because the more that you're commenting, the more that you're engaging, the more likes that those comments have, and the more likes that your video has, the higher that it's going to get pushed up in the algorithm. So definitely, definitely do that. The next tip I have is to try to keep making TikToks so that there are more on your page. So I know that this is hard, because especially for like people who have channels or are doing other things, I know the feeling, because I work, I make my two YouTube videos a week, I do my podcast, I have my house, my dog, my husband. There's a lot of things on my plate. But if you do these quick TikTok videos, then there's gonna be more on your page for when that video gets huge and blows up, for people to click on your page and to see those other videos and to start blowing those up as well. For example, some of my videos on my page have like 100 views, and now they're pretty much all of them are sitting at around 3,000 views, which is insane to me how much they've grown just from people seeing that video, clicking on my profile, and just looking to see my other videos, especially videos of Nala, because of the fact that this video was a dog video that blew up. People wanted to see more videos of Nala. It's really important. I wish that I had more videos up, because I've been really busy the past couple weeks. I haven't been making a lot of TikToks, but that's my plan for today, is to make as many as possible and put them in my draft so that I can put a couple up like every day or every couple of days. And I think that that's really good. If you have a day off or something and you can just smorgasbord and make maybe 10 videos or 5 videos. I mean, they're only a minute each, so it's not too bad. That's what my sister-in-law told me when I started making TikToks. And so that's what I'm gonna try to do. And I think that that's really good, because you never know if you have another video on your page and people start looking at it, if that one's gonna blow up as well. So try to make as many as you can. The next tip is to like your own TikToks. Okay, I do this with my TikToks, I do this with my YouTube videos as well. The more likes you get, the higher it's gonna be pushed up in the algorithm. Yes, that one like makes a huge difference, especially if you're starting off small and your videos aren't getting a ton of views. That one like is gonna make it, like, it's gonna make such a big difference. So like your TikTok videos, like your YouTube videos if you're a YouTuber as well, but especially your TikTok videos. I mean, nobody can really see that you liked it, so why not? It's gonna help push your video up, it's not gonna make you look silly, and it's gonna help you get those bigger views. The next one I have is to not get discouraged. I know how it feels. I've had my YouTube channel for 3 years, like I said, and my growth has been pretty slow. I'm really thankful for every single subscriber and every single view, but it does hurt a little bit when I'm making this much content and watching as many YouTube videos as I can to figure out how to get my channel to blow up. And sadly, the fact of the matter is that sometimes it just doesn't happen as quick as it does for other people, and that's totally okay. And like I said, don't take things down, don't do things just because they're trending, because people are looking for authenticity right now. People are looking for real people, and if you're just doing something because it's trending or doing something because people just, you think people are going to search for it, then that people are going to see that and they're not really going to be interested in watching any of your other videos. So just, I feel like just, it's hard. I know it's really hard, but don't get discouraged. Stay focused, stay on the grind, keep making videos, keep engaging with other channels and other pages, and yeah, eventually you will get there for sure. Next one is to engage with other channels and other TikTok pages because people will see your comments and then they'll click on your page and then they'll start looking through all of your stuff, and that's a great way to engage. That's also another great thing for YouTube or for Instagram, whatever you're trying to grow, is to engage with other pages and other platforms. They don't have to be huge people. It's a great way to make like friends in that community as well. Is to engage with people who may be smaller TikTokers or things of that nature, just to help your channel grow and to help make some friends and help get some followers on your page as well. My last tip for you all is to get used to the hate comments. I cannot stress this enough. I said I would talk about it a little more extensively, but I get a lot of hate comments. I get them on my YouTube videos. I get them on my Instagram, not as much, but a little bit. I get a lot of my YouTube channels, and I got so many from this viral video. The reason is people saw me playing a joke on my dog and they thought it was cruel. They thought it was mean. They didn't think it was nice. I'm gonna tell you guys a little secret, okay? This was the second time trying to film this video, because the first time I tried to film this video, Nala had no interest at all in me giving attention to the stuffed animal. So I filmed it again, and the reason I think that she's reacting the way she is because she thinks that we're playing. She was not feeling jealous in any possible way, and it just worked out for me that she bit the head off of this, or not bit it off, but bit the head of the stuffed animal because it looked like she was jealous, and it made it a really funny video, so I posted it. But people think I was being so cruel, that it was so mean to do that to my dog. And people are just mean, okay? Like somebody, this one girl called me, she told me that I sounded like a furry. No. So it's just, people are just mean. You have to let these brush off. And I'm gonna be honest, some hurt more than others. When I hear 100 times a day in the past couple days that I'm a bad dog mom, of course it's gonna hit me a little bit because I love my dog so much. If you guys watch my channel, you know that my dog is so spoiled. She sleeps on my bed, she gets treats on the daily, she gets bark boxes, we go to the PARK and go for WALKs all the time. And I don't have to justify myself to other people because I know that I'm a great dog mom. And if people want to feel that way, that's just the way they're gonna feel. And honestly, some of those people don't really feel that way. They're just looking for something to do in quarantine, or there's something, some insecurity about themselves that is hurting them, and they just are calling it out on other people. And that's totally okay. Don't let it bother you. It's people who are hiding behind a screen, and you have to realize that those people would never say that to your face if they could. So honestly, it's hard. I know it's tough, especially when you get your first couple of ones. It's gonna really sting. On my YouTube channel, I get so many that just don't even make any sense to me. Like, I just get the most random ones. So you just have to ignore it. You just have to kind of find a way to let those out. For me, I love taking baths. Like I've said, it helps get rid of all that tension and negativity in my life. I love reading. I love playing Animal Crossing. Just find a way to release that negativity from your life. And just accept the fact that hate comments are gonna happen, because there's always gonna be somebody who doesn't like you, despite, it doesn't matter what you're doing. Like, even, sorry, I'm going on a little rant now, but if you're even making a video about feeding 100,000 homeless people, there's gonna be somebody in there who says, well, you shouldn't have given them this type of protein, you should have given them this. I'm just saying, there's always gonna be hate comments. I can assure you of that. So just find a way to release it, accept them, and don't get discouraged because of the hate comments. Anyway guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope that you enjoyed it. I hope that it helped you in some way. If it did, please be sure to give it a thumbs up, and please be sure to hit the subscribe button down below so you can see more of my content in the future. And comment down below if you saw my video on TikTok and if you are here from that TikTok. And anyway guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope that you're having a wonderful, wonderful week, and I will see you on Thursday with a new vlog. Bye!